Hi children, today we are going to do the lesson which was due on the 28th of March 2020. Before starting the lesson, I want all of you to click the link for the document given below in the video description. Download and open it. Pause this video and you can play it once again once you have opened the document. If you are looking at the document now, you are ready for the lesson. So children, as usual, we are starting the lesson with the tongue twister. In the new tongue twister, we are practicing the th and the t sounds. You have to copy it down in your practical book. So with the document open in front of you, you can repeat it with me very slowly. Get the pronunciations right. I thought a thought, but the thought I thought wasn't the thought I thought I thought. If the thought I thought I thought had been thought I thought, I wouldn't have thought so much. Once more. I thought a thought, but the thought I thought wasn't the thought I thought I thought. If the thought I thought I thought had been the thought I thought, I wouldn't have thought so much. Right. So that was the tongue twister. You have to go in front of a mirror and practice it over and over again so that you can get your pronunciations right. So children, now we go to the second part of today's lesson. I have given the plot overview of the first few chapters of Oliver Twist. You have to copy this down in your theory books. In the last video, I gave you the link and I asked you to watch Oliver Twist the movie. So if you have already watched the movie, you have a general idea of what the story is all about. So I'll read through the plot overview, the part one, that is the first few chapters. You have to read it with me so that you know what exactly is happening. And children, remember, for your speech and drama exam, you're supposed to explain the story in your own words. So please pay very close attention. Ready? Oliver Twist is born in a workhouse in 1830s England. His mother, whose name no one knows, is found on the street and dies just after Oliver's birth. Oliver spends the first 9 years of his life in a badly run home for young orphans, and then is transferred to a workhouse for adults. After the other boys bully Oliver into asking for more gruel, at the end of a meal, Mr. Bumble, the parish beadle, offers £5 to anyone who will take the boy away from the workhouse. Oliver narrowly escapes being apprenticed to a brutish chimney sweep and is eventually apprenticed to a local undertaker, Mr. Sawberry. When the undertaker's other apprentice, Noah Claypool, makes disparaging comments about Oliver's mother, Oliver attacks him and incurs a Sawberry's wrath. Desperate, Oliver runs away at dawn and travels towards London. Outside London, Oliver, starved and exhausted, meets Jack Dawkins, a boy his own age. Jack offers him shelter in the London house of his benefactor, Fagin. It turns out that Fagin is a career criminal who trains orphan boys to pick pockets for him. After a few days of training, Oliver is sent on a pickpocketing mission with other two boys. When he sees them swipe a handkerchief from an elderly gentleman, Oliver is horrified and runs off. He is caught but narrowly escapes being convicted of the theft. Mr. Brownlow, the man whose handkerchief was stolen, takes the feverish Oliver to his home and nurses him back to health. Mr. Brownlow is struck by Oliver's resemblance to a portrait of a young woman that hangs in his house. Oliver thrives in Mr. Brownlow's house, but two young adults in Fagin's gang, Bill Sykes, and his lover Nancy, capture Oliver and return him to Faggy. The part we are going to do for today. Whatever questions you might have, you can always call me and ask or drop in a message. You have to copy this down in your theory books and go through this. And since you have the Longman classics of Oliver Twist, please start reading through it and answer the questions which are at the end of the book. So children, please get that work done and send me your answer scripts as well. Then we are going to the third part of today's lesson, that's improvisation. For improvisation today, I want you to get the plot overview from there, and using the book of those particular chapters, I want you to act out the character of Oliver in the workhouse. The act should be at least 1.5 minutes long. So use the setting, use appropriate costumes, and also you can use props, get the dialogues planned. So do all that. Do the video of Oliver in the workhouse and send it to me, so that I can see how well you have understood that character of the chapters that we've done as of yet. Okay children, that's the lesson for today. Any problems you have, please get back to me. I'll see you with another video of the next lesson. Bye, thank you.